Connectors rule the world. Recognizing a connector is quite easy. Well, it's a friend who goes out every day to meet some friends. Contacts are the business part of connector. In the electric world, they are the metal parts which touch each other, forming electrical connection. This is the fragile point where problems can occur, so contacts can become dirty or oxidized, and springiness or elasticity can fade with time.
Harding heavy-duty connectors were designed specially for such cases.
So you can stay with Harding connectors or you can stay with me. But today, psychology is not needed any longer. We know how to prevent it from happening. All you have to do is use gold pins or provide enough gold to cover them. Depending on the preferred outcome, you can use different types of metal or alloys. These are rhodium, zinc, silver, gold, tin, you name it. Improved corrosion resistance, strength, durability, reduced friction, increased solderability, and even changes to conductivity might all be reasons for choosing the right plating. The gold plating, although expensive, is rugged and has excellent wear properties. That is why gold is generally specified for high reliability, low voltage, or low current applications. And gold is a noble metal, so it doesn't readily react with chemicals in most environments. So gold-plated connector will retain its composure over time, even in hostile environments. The lower cost alternative with excellent solderability is the tin plating.
If a contact is mated only a few times during its lifetime, tin may be a suitable solution.
Tin plating starts to oxidize the moment it's exposed to air, so tin-plated contact system requires greater normal forces and longer wipe contact area just to break through the oxidized film. Some environments, like high temperatures, hot mating or vibrations, are completely unsuitable for tin contact system. Selective gold tin plating is also a very popular option because it gives you best of two worlds. It reduces costs and it keeps quality. The contact area, the critical area where the contact interfaces the terminal pin and the signal is transferred, has the reliability of gold. The tail, which is soldered to the board, has the lower cost and solderability of tin. Of course, there are other plating options for specific applications. Two common ones are tin lead plating and gold flash. Tin lead is used in military applications and benefits include a low eutectic temperature and the presence of lead inhibits the formation of tin whiskers. Gold for high reliability, high mating cycle and low voltage applications. Tin for applications with fewer cycles. It is less expensive and it holds solder. And selective, which is probably the best option usually, with gold in the contact and tin on the tail area. There are also multi-contact connectors. So it's like the array of connectors in a repeated pattern and the distance between them is called pitch. So they may differ according to each connector family, but not to be confused when you are buying the right mating connector or not, ask me. For example, with the MCU evaluation board, you need to connect the ribbon cable with the board's header. I know it's colorful and stuff, but you need to know how to do it. The pitch of the connector is like the distance between the pins. But if you don't have the datasheet or any reference number, measuring the pitch might be quite challenging. The pitch of a header is measured from the center of one contact to the center of the next in one row and between them. Please note that the pitch between contacts in one row and the pitch between rows may differ, so make sure you double-check the values. With connector that small, it's difficult to maintain accuracy. But you can measure pitch from the outside edge of the first pin to the inside edge of the last pin. Then count the number of pins in the row. Now you can use a simple linear equation, where A is a pitch, B is a measurement from the outside edge of the first pin to the inside edge of the last pin, and C is the number of pins. That's the equation, and that's the action. However, the pitch of the connector is not always the same as the pitch of the ribbon cable. A two-row connector with pin spacing at 254 mm will require a ribbon cable pitch at half of the connector mating pitch, 127 mm, the most common pitch on ribbon cables. Like it or not, make sure you subscribe. The next are coming. If you need more information, read the description below and have fun!